हेलो एवरीवन, टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू स्टार्ट द कल्चरल हेरिटेज ऑफ नॉर्थ ईस्टर्न रीजन. नॉर्थ ईस्टर्न रीजन, सो सी द नॉर्थ ईस्टर्न रीजन ऑफ इंडिया कंप्राइजेस 8 स्टेट्स: अरुणाचल प्रदेश, असम, मणिपुर, मेघालय, मिजोरम, नागालैंड, त्रिपुरा एंड सिक्किम. ओके, सो Each state has their own traditional beliefs and distinctive cultural heritage, and as well as its political history. But see, in spite of all these distinctive features, they also shared common features also. Okay, so government of India Form Northeastern Council. Okay, so see, the term Northeast or the Northeastern region of India actually first used by the Britishers. Okay, and see, due to its geographical location, all the states has got a different identity. Okay, but see, Assam is situated at the mid of the northeast. Okay, so the Brahmaputra and Barak river actually helped to flourish this state. Again, see, all the neighboring states of Assam are the hilly states. Okay, so Assam is used as the central place for comfortable transportation and communication. So see, In ancient times, Assam was known as Pragjyotisha or Pragjyotispur, and later as Kamarupa. Okay, so it is believed that civilization flourished or grew in this region in prehistoric days. Okay, we found written history only from 4th century AD, when the Burman kings or Burman dynasty assumed power. Okay, so the prehistoric king, the first or earliest king of Assam or prehistoric king of Assam was Mohiranga Danab. Okay, Mohiranga Danab, and he was a non-Aryan king. So Assam was ruled by from prehistoric period up to the British period. Assam was ruled by different dynasties or different powers in different period of times. So during the Ahom rules, the histories or Buranji began to record. Again, see, the ruling families of Northeast in earliest times has ties or friendship with each other through marriages, and they also help each other during the time of crisis. And Communication ran through the messengers, okay, or messengers or dut or kotokis. Okay, so barter or exchange of items like foodstuffs or clothes or other materials also took place at that time. And see, the majority of the people of this region actually Mongoloid groups, okay, from belong to Mongoloid groups, and the khasis of the Meghalaya, khasis of Meghalaya belong to Austric group, okay. So now came to the religious beliefs of northeastern region. See, the northeast we found what a mixture of cultures, okay, mixed culture. So because of the presence of various tribes, okay, we found a mixed culture, okay. So the tribes of northeast has their own religious beliefs and practices. Hinduism established its root in northeast during ancient times, and during the British rule, the Christian missionaries spread Christianity in northeastern region, okay. So though the ethnic tribes of northeast accept Hinduism, Christianity or other religions, several tribes actually followed their own religious beliefs and traditions, practices and customs, okay. And for example, some tribes of Arunachal Pradesh worship Doni Polo, and at the same time they follow Hindu, Christian and Buddhist religions, okay. In Nagaland, Hornbill Festival is celebrated, Haraka Festival is celebrated, and all these festivals are the part of the cultural heritage, okay, cultural heritage of the state. The majority of the Maitai people of Manipur are the followers of the Chaitanya cult, okay. And the impact of Vaishnavism or impact of Vaishnava religion, okay, is seen in their religious practices or beliefs, their dances and musical instruments, songs, etc., okay. But with this some of the Manipuri people are still animist, okay, still animist. So animist meaning see worshipper of rocks, plants and animals, etc., okay. So the culture of Tripura is a mixed culture, okay. Culture consists of ethnic the Tripura is a mixed culture and consists of ethnic tribes, Hinduism, especially Bengali culture. So we found Bengali influence of Bengali culture in Tripura because of its Bengali population, okay. The Khasi, the Jayanti and Garo people are of Meghalaya accept the Christianity from 1830 AD, okay, 1830 AD. And specially see the society of Meghalaya is actually matriarchal society, okay. So the people of Mizoram known as Mizos, and majority of them are the Christians, and some follow Buddhism and Hinduism. Again, see their territory, their traditional festival is known as Chapcharkut, and the people of Sikkim follow the religion Hinduism and Vajrayana Buddhism, okay, Vajrayana form of Buddhism. So see Mahayana Buddhism, Hinayana Buddhism and the Vajrayana form of Buddhism. So in here the Vajrayana form is a tantric form of Buddhism, okay, tantric form of Buddhism. So in the northeast we found various tribes and see because of this number of tribes, we found what a diversity, okay, a diversity or a mixed culture. So their food habits, their dress, their dances, their songs, their instruments, their festivals, their dialects, beliefs, etc., are different from each other, okay, but they collectively held what the cultural heritage of northeast. Okay, their cultural heritage of northeast. And again, see, the people of hills. The people of hills are generally hard worker because of their hard life and livelihood. Okay, so in the hilly areas, they practices are jhum cultivation. Okay, jhum cultivation, and in the plains, the people practices what the wet rice cultivation. Okay, so now came to the part of Assam. So among the states of the northeast region, Assam has the most varied cultural tradition, or has its own cultural tradition, cultural heritage. Okay, and the Brahmaputra Valley added to its richness. Okay, so see, at the in earliest times, Assam was connected with China, and the China was connected to Roman Empire through the Silk Route. Okay, the Silk Route. so see, from ancient times, different groups of people came to Assam for various reasons, for business, for pilgrimage, for invasions. Okay, and they stayed here. Okay, they some of them, so not actually all, some of them stayed here. Okay, so today we found what a mixture of culture. Okay, so I already mentioned that the name of Assam, the earliest name of Assam is Pragjyotishar, Pragjyotishpur, and later as Kamrup. Okay, so these names are found in the sources or writings, including Ramayana, Mahabharata, Vishnu Puran, Kalika Puran, Yogini Tantra, or the writings of Huyen Sang. So Huyen Sang came to Assam during the reign of Bhaskar Barman, okay, the last powerful ruler of the Barman dynasty. And the history writing process was start during the Ahom rule. Okay, during the Ahom rule, and before that we found these writings, Ramayana, Mahabharata, Vishnu Puran, Yogini Tantra, Kalika Puran, and there we found the name of Assam, or some topography about Assam, all this geographical location, or some myths or legends about Assam. Okay, and see, the modern name of Assam. So some expert opine that the name Assam Assam emerged from the Sanskritization of the words Acham or Hasam, used by Ahom and the Boro people respectively. So now came to the literature part. To see, so if you have good literature, you have a rich literature. If you have a rich literature, then you have a good language. Okay, good language or rich language. So see, from the Barman dynasty, they Sanskrit and Assamese. So first Barman dynasty first used Sanskrit as official language, and later they used Assamese as official language. Okay, so this Assamese language, according to some experts or historians, that what this Assamese language actually evolved from the Sanskrit language. Okay, evolved from the Sanskrit language. And see, the modern form of Assamese language developed modern form of Assamese language we found in the journal Arunodoy. Okay, in journal magazine Arunodoy in 1846 AD. Okay, so see, now came to the literature. See here, we found two types of literature. see pre-Sankardev era, okay, pre-Sankardev era literature and Sankara era and post-Sankara, three types of literature, sorry, Assamese literature, pre-Sankardeva era, Sankardeva era and the post-Sankardeva era, okay. So see, 10th century to 14th century AD, we found what? A collection of songs. In Assamese literature, a collection of songs known as Sarjapads, okay, Sarjapads. And from 14th century onwards, Hem Saraswati, Rudra Kandali, Harihar Vipra, okay, in your book it's Haribar Vipra, mentioned as Haribar Vipra, not actually Haribar Vipra, it's Harihar Vipra, okay. So Kabiratna Saraswati and Madhav Kandali created in verse form, okay, in verse form. See, first we found Sarjapads in songs, okay, collection of songs, okay. Then Harihar Vipla, Hem Saraswati, Rudra Kandali, etc. Composed or created Assamese literature in verse form, okay. So here verse, what is verse? See, writing arranged with a metrical rhythm. Writing arranged with a metrical rhythm or like rhymes, okay, like rhymes. Is known as verse form, okay, it's known as verse form. And see, Madhav Kandali was patronized. So here see, these poets, these scholars, these scholars were patronized, okay, these scholars were patronized or supported, financially supported by the rulers, okay, like Barahi kings, king of Kamata or the Ahom rulers, okay. So under the patronization of these kings, under the patronization of these kings, these scholars like Madhav Kandali, Hem Saraswati, Rudra Kandali, Harihar Vipra, Kabiratna Saraswati composed or create a rich Assamese literature in verse form. Okay, so now came to the Vaishnavite period. Okay, now come to Vaishnavite period from 15th century AD. Okay, from 15th century AD. So from 15th century AD, Sankardeva and Madhav Deva created Assamese literature, okay. So see, created Assamese literature and they preach Neo Vaishnavite movement, okay. They preach Neo Vaishnavite movement and they compose see lot of poetry, songs, prose, Saritputhi. So Saritputhi here is a biographies, okay, biographies of the Guru Sarit or Sarit Puthis are the biographies of these preachers, okay, religious preachers, okay, religious preachers of Neo Vaishnavite movement, okay, drama, etc. So, see, there are some main subject matters or literary works are Ramayana, Mahabharata, Purana, and theories of Hindu religion, etc., okay. So, Sankardeva's Kirtan, Madhav Deva's Nam Ghosa, and Borgit's were most popular in Assam, okay, in Assam and beyond Assam, okay. So Sankardeva wrote six dramas, okay, or Ankyanes or plays, okay. See, Patni Prasad, Kaliadaman, Keli Gopal, Rukmini Haran, Parizat Haran, Ram Bijay, and these are known as plays. এই অংকীয়া নাটকীখনক কি বুলি কয় শংকৰদেৱৰ দুই প দুই ক দুই ৰ পাৰিজাত হৰণ পত্নী প্ৰসাদ ৰুক্মিণী হৰণ ৰাম বিজয় কেলি গোপাল কালীয় দমন অ'কে দধি মথন অফ মাধৱদেৱ এণ্ড হিজ ঝুমুৰা চৌধুৰা এণ্ড পিম্পৰা গছৰ আৰ ফেমাছ অ'কে সুচি এগেইন চি Sankardeva established satras and namghars for the propagation of Neo Vaishnavite movement. And actually, he, Sankardeva and his disciple Madhav Deva, not only propagate or preach Neo Vaishnavite movement, actually they were the builder, okay, they were the builder of the Assamese society, they were the builder of Assamese society, Assamese literature, Assamese culture, okay, and they Sankardev introduced Ek Saran Bhagavati Dharma, Ek Saran Nam Dharma or Nam Kirtan, okay, to unite the all the Assamese people, not the Assamese people, all the people of Assam, including the tribes or irrespective of caste and creed. Irrespective of caste and creed, Sankardev actually tried to unite all the people of Assam. Okay. So he introduced Neo Vaishnavite movement. So he established Satra, Namghar, and he established Ek Saran Bhagavati Dharma or Ek Saran Nam Kirtan. Okay, Nam Kirtan. So he introduced Nam Kirtan. And see the first Nat or Sinha Jatra. First Nat or first play Sinha Jatra of Sankardeva was written and staged before the Shakespeare's dramas. Okay, Shakespeare's drama. And see the Brindabani Bastra. Brindabani Bastra is a great textile designer work. Okay, and there we found what seven heaven. Okay, seven Hat Boikuntho. Ami tat ami ki pam tat picture pam. Hai na picture pam Hat Boikuntho picture ami kot pam Brindabani Bastra. And this textile designer Brindabani Bastra has been preserved in British Museum and some parts are preserved in other famous museums. Okay. So again see after Sankardev. So after Sankardev or post Sankardev era, prominent writers like Bhattadeva, Ananta Kandali, Ram Saraswati keep up the tradition of Assamese literature. Okay, and Bhattadev. Boikunthanath Bhattadev was the first Assamese prose writer. Okay, first Assamese prose writer. So here see prose meaning written or spoken language in its ordinary form. Okay, prose meaning what? Written or spoken language in its ordinary form. So Bhattadev, Boikunthanath Bhattadev composed or wrote what? Prose. Okay, he was the first prose writer. And his writings like see Katha Gita, Katha Bhagavat or Ratnavali, Katha, etc. Okay. After that, Pitambar Kabi, Durgabar Kayastha, Sukabi Narayan Dev, etc. also enriched Assamese literature with their works. And see, here important the Paidya Gita written by Govinda Mishra. Paidya Gita written by Govinda Mishra in 16th century is still widely popular. See, Paidya Gita meaning see poetic translation of Gita. Okay, poetic translation of Gita is known as Paidya Gita. Okay, and again see I already told that history is written where it began under the patronage of Ahom kings, and it also enriched Assamese literature. And after that, the other histories like the Odhai history, Dungkhungya history, Kachari history, Zayantia history, Tripura history were began to compose or record. And these history writings or the record. Also enriched Assamese literature. Okay, enriched Assamese literature. And the modern Assamese language or modern Assamese language evolved from the time of Arunodoy. From the time of Arunodoy from 1846 AD. Okay, so that's all for today's class. So in the next class we discuss about religions, art and paintings. Okay, goodbye.